Here we go. Hi. Well, I'm here at the airport in New Orleans, and I wanted to videotape this part so I could sort of wrap up this journey for the last week, and it's been extraordinary. As a lawyer and as a person, I can tell you that what I've seen and experienced in the last 7 days is something straight out of a John Grisham novel. And if I would have never been able to predict what BP has done and has tried to do against these people. It started with a trip down to Venice, which is at the very end of nowhere in Louisiana. We saw Obama's motorcade. I did a news story for CBS News, and on the way back, came into contact with some Vietnamese and Cambodian fishermen. And quite frankly, I didn't even know they existed in this part of the world. And then what happened was we found out about contracts and waivers and things that were provided to these people, not in their own language, and things that were not explained to them. And they became desperate and hungry and were willing to do anything, including risking their own lives and their ships to go out there and try to clean up BP's mess. So I went from lawyer to civil rights worker, and I created a town hall meeting, worked with United Way and the church, the Catholic Church Archdiocese, and the parish president and parish council members and leaders from the Cambodian and Vietnamese community to try to help these people. And unfortunately, after a week of working with them, I really don't have all that good of news to report. I did promise them that I would try to get food on their table by the end of the week, and unfortunately I got some food on some people's tables today with the help of the Archdiocese, but most of it was rotten and not the kind of foods that they would even eat. What's more important is they get money, and we have that link set up with the United Way. But as I left Plaxman's Parish today, the United Way had the money, gave it to the Catholic Archdiocese Church, Catholic Services, and they hadn't figured out a way to disperse it to these people. So sadly, as of Friday night, and I'm heading home to Miami to be with my own family and spend Mother's Day with my wife and my mom, I have sad news to report that these people who go unrepresented and still haven't been helped and haven't received a dime from BP as of today will just try to have to survive a few more days. I'll do everything I can when I get back next week, and we'll continue the struggle on their behalf. The LA Times in today's newspaper wrote a cover story about this, and I hope that this will create some additional interest on behalf of these people. They are Americans, and they need our help, and this journey will continue. Thank you.